सर्वमदं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सर्वकर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व नियंत्रित्व विवर्जितं सकलागम संवेद्यं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सर्वकर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व नियंत्रित्व विवर्जितं सकलागम संवेद्यं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सर्वकर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व नियंत्रित्व विवर्जितं सकलागम संवेद्यं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सर्वकर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व नियंत्रित्व विवर्जितं सकलागम संवेद्यं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सृष्टि स्थिति लयाधारं गुणागुण विवर्जितं सर्व चैतन्य संपूर्णं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सृष्टि स्थिति लयाधारं गुणागुण विवर्जितं सर्व चैतन्य संपूर्णं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सृष्टि स्थिति लयाधारं गुणागुण विवर्जितं सर्व चैतन्य संपूर्णं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सृष्टि स्थिति लयाधारं गुणागुण विवर्जितं सर्व चैतन्य संपूर्णं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
नित्यानंदं निर्विकारं ज्ञान भावानुबोधकं सदालंबं नित्यदृप्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
नित्यानंदं निर्विकारं ज्ञान भावानुबोधकं सदालंबं नित्यदृप्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
नित्यानंदं निर्विकारं ज्ञान भावानुबोधकं सदालंबं नित्यदृप्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
नित्यानंदं निर्विकारं ज्ञान भावानुबोधकं सदालंबं नित्यदृप्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
संसार सागरोद्धारं योगी हृद् पद्म मंदिरं महाभावं शुद्धचित्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
संसार सागरोद्धारं योगी हृद् पद्म मंदिरं महाभावं शुद्धचित्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
संसार सागरोद्धारं योगी हृद् पद्म मंदिरं महाभावं शुद्धचित्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
संसार सागरोद्धारं योगी हृद् पद्म मंदिरं महाभावं शुद्धचित्तं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
श्री शंकरांश संभूतं सच्चिदानंद रूपिणं नाद बिंदु कलादिदं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
श्री शंकरांश संभूतं सच्चिदानंद रूपिणं नाद बिंदु कलादिदं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
श्री शंकरांश संभूतं सच्चिदानंद रूपिणं नाद बिंदु कलादिदं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
श्री शंकरांश संभूतं सच्चिदानंद रूपिणं नाद बिंदु कलादिदं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
निर्गुणं निर्मलं शांतं निरावासं निरंजनं निरालंबं जगत्पूज्यं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
निर्गुणं निर्मलं शांतं निरावासं निरंजनं निरालंबं जगत्
निरालंबं जगत्पूज्यं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
निर्गुणं निर्मलं शांतं निरावासं निरंजनं निरालंबं जगत्पूज्यं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
परं ज्योतिस्वरूपं तं सर्वसाक्षिस्वरूपिणं सर्वकार्य समुत्सागं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
परं ज्योतिस्वरूपं तं सर्वसाक्षिस्वरूपिणं सर्वकार्य समुत्सागं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
परं ज्योतिस्वरूपं तं सर्वसाक्षिस्वरूपिणं सर्वकार्य समुत्सागं नित्य नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
परं ज्योतिस्वरूपं तं सर्वसाक्षिस्वरूपिणं सर्वकार्य समुत्साहं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
अवधूतं महात्मानं मुनि योगीश सेवितं सन्मुनीन्द्र शिरोरत्नं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
अवधूतं महात्मानं मुनि योगीश सेवितं सन्मुनीन्द्र शिरोरत्नं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
अवधूतं महात्मानं मुनि योगीश सेवितं सन्मुनीन्द्र शिरोरत्नं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
अवधूतं महात्मानं मुनि योगीश सेवितं सन्मुनीन्द्र शिरोरत्नं नित्यानंद गुरुं भजे।
सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. Before entering into the program, Kalpataru, just few understandings for newcomers. Usually, we conduct 4-day meditation workshop, 4-day program to give a glimpse of that higher consciousness. Super consciousness. I call it Nityananda Spurana. I have condensed the essence in one day. I'm trying to give a strong spiritual awakening in one day. So few things need to be attended. I need a little more cooperation from you. I don't have time to logically analyze and support every statement I am making. I have time in 4-day workshop. Whatever I am talking is very clear, logical, experiential truth, which can be experienced. But now, because it is one day, I don't have much time to analyze every statement. I am just presenting the direct experiential truth to you directly. So I need you to be a little more aware, alert, intense. Why I support every argument, every idea logically? Because many times when things are uttered, we are not aware, we just relax. If 10 statements are uttered, one or two only you grasp. Psychiatrists say only 2% we grasp. Only 2%. If 100 things are happening around us, we grasp only 2%. We respond to only 2%. If you are hypnotized, only then you reveal what all is recorded inside you. If 100 things are recorded inside you, in your unconscious, you respond only to 2 things. If you are in that awareness, I think you will miss a lot. I want you to be intense, be aware, because even if you miss one statement, you may miss the whole essence. You may miss the experience, what I call Kalpataru. So all I request is be intense, be aware, completely involved I have seen in the 4-day meditation workshop, people will start meditating only from third day. But I don't want you to wait till third day. Please start from the first session. From the first session. Because we have only one day. Please, you don't have to wait. Usually, people don't start connecting. They wait to be intellectually tortured. Now that is what is the right word. Going on, giving arguments, logic. This is nothing but intellectual torture. I request you, please don't wait to be intellectually tortured. I'm straight away sharing the experiences and techniques and experience it. Experience doesn't need intellectually to experience the truth. You don't need to be intellectually tortured. But we are not convinced. We don't want to settle down. We don't want to relax. We don't want to connect. Then nothing else can be done. I have to go on using all kinds of words. This one day, we don't have time to use too many words. I'll straight away present simple truths. Internalize it and start meditating. Start experiencing. Let me introduce the word Kalpadaru. In Sanskrit, the literal translation, literal meaning, the Kalpadaru word is Sanskrit word. Literal meaning is fulfilling your wishes, the tree which fulfills your wishes. Kalpataru means, kalpa means whatever you can visualize. Taru means the tree which fulfills it. Please understand. Fulfilling does not mean giving. There is a subtle difference. Many times giving does not gives you fulfillment. If your desire is given, what you asked is given, the fulfillment doesn't happen. What for you asked, if that is provided, only then fulfillment happens. There is a subtle difference between what you ask and what for you ask. Many times we achieve what we ask, but what for we ask is never achieved. I have seen people going through the depression of success. They achieve what they want, house, car, bank balance, relationship. They achieve all that. But what far they want to achieve, that they are not able to achieve. Because whenever you wish for something, you always have a feeling, if I achieve this, I'll be settled. If I achieve this, I'll be settled. But after achieving that object, suddenly you realize you are not settled. You are not fulfilled. That's what I call depression of success. I've seen so many people, before achieving something, they think if I achieve that, I'll be completely fulfilled and settled. But after achieving, they are in opposite mood. Completely opposite mood. You can see from your young age. The moment you start feeling the individual identity, you have some deep emptiness. From that moment, we feel a deep emptiness. First we think, if I am educated, and I'll be settled in the life, that emptiness will disappear. After education, we think, no, if I am employed, and if I am standing on my own, that emptiness will disappear. After that, we think, no, if I am married and have love in my life, that emptiness will disappear. After marriage, if I have kids and a family, the emptiness will disappear. After that, no, if I have a house and car, emptiness will disappear. After that, if my son stands on his own feet, emptiness will disappear. Then, I think, if he gets married, I think I am settled. When he gets married, no. If I have my grandkids, I am settled. Till you settle down in the tomb, graveyard, we don't feel we are settled. That emptiness which starts the moment you feel the individual identity continues to drive your life crazy. It is continuously driving your life crazy. The big problem is, if whatever people tell, you believe and start doing it. If somebody says, with money that emptiness will disappear, you run behind money. If somebody says, no, with good relationships, that emptiness will disappear, you start running behind. If somebody says, no, if you have a position in the society and security, the emptiness will disappear. Big problem is, you are running behind the goals set by the people who themselves have not experienced the fulfillment. They themselves have not experienced the fulfillment, but they are setting the goal. You are running behind that goal. That is what we call Maya. Maya means Yama iti Maya, which is not there, but which makes you run with fear and greed as if it is there. Yama iti Maya, in Sanskrit we say, which is not there, but which makes you continuously feel, which creates the responses of fear and greed in you as if it is there. We are running behind the goals set by the people who have not experienced fulfillment by themselves. Kalpadaru means which can fulfill your visualizations. Sometime it may give what you want. Sometime it may take you beyond what you want. Fulfillment. In each one of us, that energy, the fulfillment is there. These are all, please understand, I am not repeating the same old things which you heard or read in books. When I am saying, I am responsible for it. But now, when I say this fulfillment is inside you, I am responsible for my words. You can ask me. I am responsible for what I am talking. So please understand, I am not repeating from any book. I am not repeating from any theory. Whatever you listen from me, I am responsible for it. You can very clearly understand, I am responsible for what I am talking. The fulfillment is inside you. It is there. And we have experienced, even now, rarely we experience. One big problem is, human beings when they walk, they leave their footprint. The birds don't leave their footprint. Same way, suffering leaves samskara, engram, memory in you. But fulfillment, which you experience in your life, rarely doesn't leave footprint, doesn't leave any memory inside you. That is why you don't remember the moments when you experienced fulfillment. But you can always recall the moments which you experienced suffering. The painful moments you can always recall and remember, recollect, cherish. That's what we are doing whole day. Whole day we are doing that only. Constantly we bring our past back. Actually, if you have any problem directly, any pain, suffering, we are very comfortable with the present moment. We think, oh, life is going as it should be. If nothing is there, if everything goes well, we feel empty and lonely. First thing, oh, if everything is going smooth today, tomorrow it is going to be a very bad day. That is our mind. Then, even if that is not satisfying, we bring all the old memories. See, what happened to me a few days before? That shouldn't have happened. This shouldn't have happened. We cherish. In a way, we are habituated to cherish suffering. We are habituated to cherish pains. We are trained. We are enjoying. If they are not there, we are missing something. We feel lonely. They become our company. Fulfillment does not leave imprint, does not leave engram in us. It is a gap